Yo, what's up, guys? It is Deltre. We are back with some more Fire Emblem Fates Lunatic Conquest, and I wanted to start this video so badly by doing this, but I don't have the heart. I don't have the heart. So instead, I'm just gonna tell you guys what you have won, because oh my god, that did not take very long. You guys came through and then some. Jesus Christ. So, in the mystery box is Night Breaks Through the proper way. God, I'm not looking forward to that, man. I have never actually beaten Endgame Lunatic Conquest, like, the proper way, like, the actual way. And if you don't know, you can use the rescue scap. You can use the rescue staff to essentially skip over the vast majority of that map. I think you can do it in... Is it a one turn or is it two? I can't remember, honestly. I'm sort of familiar with the strategy, but I haven't had to do it in a long time, so forgive me. Bottom line, that's not going to be happening, so that's just great. Shut up, Kata. Anyways, last time. Last time we did Dwyer's map, but there's not really a whole lot to say about that. I don't think I talked about his growth, so maybe while we're talking about the rest of this, they may be on screen or something like that. Still think he's one of the best kids, but actually, he's probably not doing as much today as I thought he was, which I'll get into. Before that, though, I'd actually posed a few questions to you guys, and you guys came through for sure, without a doubt. It was definitely interesting seeing a lot of different perspectives on that. The first thing, though, was Chapter 21 itself. Now, I saw a few different reasonings for why that might not be such a great map for some people. I will say that I don't necessarily agree with a lot of it. And I don't mind if you disagree with me even still, that's totally fine. The one thing that I definitely do have to admit, though, is the fact that in Conquest, particularly now, you're sort of forced to use certain characters on certain maps, especially. Like, the End of the Staircase is a great example of that. There's, without a doubt, a certain minimum number of royals that you would have to deploy in order to do that effectively. In fact, we might be able to just go back to the map. Hold up. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure what the minimum number would be. Probably, I want to say... Let's see, I used Dude for this one. I used her for the first one as well, and I also used her for this one. But Camilla could do all of that, I think. I mean, you would have had to give her the boots, because I did need a 10-move flyer specifically for this strategy, but I think you could do it with Camilla. If you didn't have, like, a Wyvern dude. And that's another thing I will say. It's very beneficial for me, without a doubt, that I have a lot of flyers here. But let's not forget, it's not like you need Mozu, right? There's always Baruka, who can do basically everything that Mozu has done this entire game, to be honest. Gunter makes very good use of the heart seals that you can now buy unlimited, at this point, I do believe. Yeah, you can buy them at unlimited quantities. So, that's always an option. I think that there are enough outs, but at the end of the day, you do need a royal to do that. And that is something that if they were to revisit in Three Houses, I kind of hope that they just make it so that every character can interact with these, like, these glowing map spots or whatever you want to call them. I hope that everybody can interact with the maps, basically, because that would just be better, really, because then it's more of a choice, you know what I mean? Because I can't really... Again, I can't really do too much if I don't have at least two Dragon Bane users on this map. That would be like the bare minimum. But that's only on Lunatic mode, however. If you go down on lower difficulties, you may notice... This is a great feature, by the way, especially for trying to prove a point like this, but... You can go down to Hard. Classic, sure. And go back onto the map, and then we'll actually see that there are significantly more Dragon Banes. Actually, I think on Hard there's only one more Dragon Bane, and it's right here. Yeah, so if you look at it, though, it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I guess you would need to use Azura to get to this one from this one. Or if you had a flyer, say, over here on the same turn that you hit this one, you could hit this one as well. And that would... Basically, well, I guess it doesn't even have to be a flyer, really, right? Because it could just be anybody over here. And then they would be able to hit this one as well. So even if you didn't have a bunch of flyers like I did, on Lunatic, on difficulties below that, I should say, it's really a non-issue. You can hit every single one. And don't get me wrong, I didn't let the enemies move on this map, but you don't have to. You can let them get a turn or two. You just really don't want to let them be doing that too much. And where I kind of really disagree with some of the criticisms is that it seemed to be that the main argument against this map was that it was just kind of too hard to just break through. And I'm sorry, guys. I can't get behind that at all. I don't feel like purchasing a game automatically earns you the right to defeat it on its highest difficulty. I'm not saying that anybody said that specifically, but I feel that on a mode called Lunatic, you should have to be somewhat crazy to actually complete it. And I don't mean complete it well, necessarily. I just mean to simply beat the mode, you should be good. You know? There should be challenges. You shouldn't just be able to use the same strategy every single map. You know? And this is a map that just does not lend itself well to defensive play, and I think that that's perfectly fair. If every single map could be defeated in the same way, then why even call it Lunatic? It's not really challenging if I know my one and only go-to move from Chapter 1, you know what I mean? So I just can't agree with the fact that its difficulty makes it bad automatically. Same with the Stoneboard being so strong. I think that's genuinely a good thing, because now I, as a player, have to make a choice here. If they were really weak, right? Let's say they don't even one-shot Felicia, which they actually don't now that we're on hard mode. I can just give her a tonic and she survives. So there's always that. Felicia's not getting one-shot, which means basically nobody is but Azura. But let's say they did one-shot her. So now I have to make a choice, right? I have to either find a way to deal with these guys before moving in Azura, or I can't move her in at all. So now I have to somehow find a way to kill this guy, and on Lunatic mode there's a guy right here, so I have to somehow devise a way to do that, but they're really hard to one round KO, so maybe I want to use like a skill or something, and at this point we're playing a game, right? At this point we're devising a strategy, so I think that's a good thing, right? I don't know, I definitely do see the Royals point though, and since we're actually going to be doing Chapter 22 today and not Ophelia's Paralogue, because I remember that Elise is a Malik Knight. And I mean, if we're gonna do Ophelia, let's do Ophelia, right? Let's pass her trample and crap and make her really, really broken. So we'll probably wait like a map or two before getting her. But yeah, that said, this next map is almost certainly gonna demonstrate the Royal Curse in full effect. That said, I actually haven't looked at this map because it took me until today to realize that Elise is a goddamn bitch. I can't believe I forgot that, especially with how much work she's been putting in. And I used her like 2 days ago. 2 days ago, and I didn't even stop to think, hey, maybe get trampled before we do the paralogues. Where to even begin with this story, though, right? So you guys actually did give me a lot of good information that I didn't really know. So apparently this game was going to be very, very different originally. And not only that, but Lilith seems to be implied to have had some significant impact on the narrative originally. So that would explain why she even dies at all, right? Why would she die if not for the fact that originally she must have meant something? But speaking of which, you can still feed Lilith for some reason. But at any rate, originally she was apparently very important, and the DLC would seem to back this up. And this one was really shocking to me. I guess if you care about spoilers for the DLC, just skip ahead a little bit. But apparently, Lilith is actually Corrin's sister? What? How do you not put that in the game? Seriously, how would you... How? I can't even... Why didn't they just say that? Why was that not part of the game? Had that been part of the game, everything actually starts to make a little bit more sense, doesn't it? So why would they not just indicate that at any point? I guess... No, there's no I guess. That's just bad, man. That's just bad. I can't believe that. And also, based on some of the stuff you guys were telling me, I decided to do a little bit of research, because this whole game, like I was saying, this whole game feels very, very inconsistent. And as best I could tell, the story goes something like this, okay? So there were basically two schools of thought when devising how they wanted to design Fates or whatever, and there was like the sort of team pandering, I guess, where they were they wanted to do a bunch of like really out there sort of, I don't know, unnecessary stuff, let's say. stuff like the goddamn letter in Revelation. If you don't know what I'm talking about, it's easily the worst thing to come out of that game. But if you don't know, it goes a little something like this. Corrin is not actually related to Ryoma, Hinoka, whatever. She's not related to any of them. Which, need I even remind you guys, is the whole reasoning for this game even existing. Yeah, the entire conflict here is predicated on the fact that dude is actually related to the birthright siblings. But she's not. So, in other words, why are we fighting? They actually tried to pin her so hard that they defeated the purpose of the game. But yeah, there's that whole mess that is Revelation, and I presume that team pandering was behind that. Now, there was another group, or like another school of thought from the developers, and this is where we get stuff that makes a little bit more sense. This is why we have Conquest to begin with, because one team did not agree with the other, so we have team pandering, and then I guess we can call the other team Team Reasonable, I guess, because it seems like they had their shit together a little bit more than the other team. But that would explain why it feels like this game was made by, like, a million different people. There's no unified direction here, or at least it certainly doesn't feel like that to me. And by the way, how salty do you think that Team Reasonable was after they saw the criticisms that this game got? Like, if it were me, I would just be such a prick about it. I would never stop saying I told you so. That would be the most awkward week at the office ever after reviews started rolling out. I'm not even kidding, dude. And I think it's hilarious that the only thing Nintendo could think to do after seeing the reception Fates Stories got was release literally the polar opposite game. They remade Echoes, a game that could not be more different than Fates if it tried. That's how badly they wanted to change the tune of this series, dude. But yeah, I thought that was really interesting. And one comment I actually did want to draw special attention to was this one by Blade of Light. And I wanted to bring this up because I thought that, one, this takes a big person to admit that there are flaws with something that you enjoy. But I thought it was interesting because I can kind of understand where this person is coming from, right? I can remember playing the original Fire Emblem 7 on Game Boy Advance, having the tactician named after myself, and whenever Lin would turn to the screen and be like, "Oh, what do you think, Deltry?" You know, I thought that was pretty cool. Even in that case, it's not nearly as intrusive as this game, in my opinion. You know, it's just really not. But I thought that took a lot of guts, especially considering how willing some people are to jump down their fellow fans' throats at times, you know what I mean? So thank you to the person for sharing that, and I'm glad to actually have a little bit of perspective on what the appeal actually is here. That said, I think we're actually gonna do this next map live. I usually do think these through a little bit. I will say I don't think I think these through nearly as much as some of you guys would seem to suggest. No, I basically know the first turn and the last turn, and then everything else I'm just kind of freestyling, guys. It just happens to be that Conquest is a well-designed game. That's really all that's happening here, I promise. But yeah, since I think we're gonna try to do that live, just I guess to drive home that point that it doesn't take long to do what I'm doing, I promise. But that said, I probably will just stick to the supports that I know we're still gonna be working on, which would be like Arthur, Camilla. Actually, you know what? No, I forgot. I can just go to the records hall and do them that way. So yeah, actually, I really want to try to do this live, I guess, or like figure out the map live. So I don't know how long that will take me necessarily. So I think it would be more intelligent to just do the map, right? And then we'll see what happens. I can always go back and do the supports in the thing. Yeah, so I guess let's just jump in, give this a shot, see what happens. Dude's group nears the Hoshido capital, but they must first conquer Virginia. The real challenge will not come in the form of a battle, however. I disagree. I disagree. I think the only challenger is the battle, in fact. For chapter 22, Sakura. Now, who could the boss be here? Who could it possibly be? Must be Kurth Naga. I don't know why I thought of that, but I just remembered how Radiant Dawn tries to act like Kurth is not the... You know what, never mind. This is it, Fort Ginya. This is essentially Hoshido's front line. It is rumored to be impregnable. Seizing it is tantamount to conquering Hoshido. We must not fail. Of course it's impregnable. Yeah, Bottle's impregnable is Ostia, actually. Why is it never easy?
Be careful.
We should brace ourselves. We will likely be battling people we know in there.
Yeah.
I'm ready. We've made it this far. There's no turning back now. It's just like Xander said. No matter who we lose, or who we end up hurting, we must do what... Why is this so hard? We must do what we must do to bring peace to this war-torn land. There we go. I knew I'd get there eventually.
You're right. Even if I must defeat the siblings I grew up with, it is for a higher purpose. Neither of us should regret the events to come. We're in this together, dude. I will follow you to the end.
Azura.
Thank you, Azura. I've been saying Azura. Thank you, Azura. Your support gives me strength. Does it? I don't think it does. It gives you speed, right?
Well, there's no reason to postpone this any longer. The soldiers here have likely already realized we're here. We should attack first before they do. Let's go.
I could not agree more, however. However, I don't know how easy it's really going to be. This map is actually really good. We're going into the end game of Conquest, which I can't immediately think of any maps that suck. There are aspects of the final map that sucks, to be sure. Namely, the fact that you can't save in between that and the map before it. So, look forward to that. Look forward to me failing on the final map and then having to replay two maps, I guess.
Oh, what did Yukimura even sound like? Lady Sakura, what are you still doing here? You must escape now.
What?
Well, what's the matter, Yukimura? You're out of breath.
Goddamn, Yukimura. Smoker's cough.
Milady, you must stop healing our soldiers and retreat. There isn't a moment to lose. Lady Dude and her army are outside the fort, preparing for battle.
Dude's here. Whoa. I see. Then I will join the fight.
You mustn't.
You mustn't. You don't know what you're saying. You need to get back to the castle, right?
I refuse.
I will not leave.
Lady Sakura.
I'm sorry about this.
Exactly. I'm sorry, Yukimura. I know you're only looking out for me. But I'm no longer a powerless princess. I've leveled up so many times. I will fight for my kingdom. Still have that stutter though, I see. I refuse to leave these soldiers behind and be the only one who escapes. Please, Yukimura, please try to understand.
Lady Sakura, well, your funeral.
My word.
My word, what to do. Lord Ryoma would kill me for this, but... if it means that much to you to stay, then I shall not force you to retreat. But only if you allow me to arrange for your protection. We shall fight together.
Yes.
Thank you, Yukimura.
And yeah, there's actually two bosses here, right? Yeah. Yeah, so here we go. So, if I were just gonna spitball this, I guess... the first thing I would do is look at Yukimura because he's the boss. So if I want to kill Yukimura, right, I need 25 damage times 2. Yeah, I'll need 25 times 2. So that means that on the throne he has 27 defense, giving me a total of 52 attack. Do I have anybody that can do that? Probably Camilla pretty easily. She doesn't have trample yet, but even had she already obtained the skill, I don't think it would matter at this point because Yukimura is in fact mounted. Or at least I'm like 99% sure the mechanists are in fact mounted. I have yet to see anything that would make me believe otherwise. Yeah, we can definitely do that with Camilla. 4 from the mess hall, and then like 5 or 6 from Arthur should just put her there by default. And that's with the dual club. I could actually give her a stronger weapon, and she could do it more easily. If I want her to double, she needs 31 speed, which is really easy to get, because I think Arthur does it mostly by himself, and then again, the mess hall would do that. Now, we have these dragon veins here as well, and as I recall... yeah, they leapfrog off of each other like that, so we have to go right, left, right, left, right, left. We need to hit this one for sure, this one for sure, this one for sure, this one for sure, and this one for sure. Because dude starts over here, and I can put Camilla over here, and we can break through to Yukimura. Right? Does that make sense? Because you can see the dragon veins, they all just, like, they bounce off of each other like that. So you can't do the same side twice if you want to move effectively here, is kind of what I'm seeing. Because it would be much faster to just simply go through the wall than it would be to, like, walk around this way. And there's also, like, this whole situation with ballisticians. If we go through this area, I think that, yeah, Sakura herself actually has some stabs. Now, you don't have to kill Sakura. It is a seize map. I do remember that. So... we don't actually have to deal with her at all if we don't want to. I would like to. She does drop a spirit dust, but I think it could be kind of tricky to both push this side and also this side at the same time. It seems like you would almost have to take an extra turn because I can't see having both enough Dragon Bane users on this side and this side as well, you know what I mean? To hit every single one. I guess we can also look at the enemies as well. Looks like the Oni Chieftains... Well, their res is comparatively terrible, so I guess this is Elisa's job. She would need 39 attack times 2. Can she do that? Let's say I went with a magic mess hall on top of a strength mess hall and then just tried to boost my speed, because these guys aren't really that bad. I mean, there's Hana, which we can figure that out in a second, I guess. But they're not really too fast, right? So that makes sense. If I gave her the magic and then plus 2 from Odin, because he would actually be giving plus 2 at S, puts us up to 37, and then plus 2 from Atana gives us 39. There you go, this is Elise, I think. Although these guys do hit her incredibly hard. But that's a really big if as well, because she's going to have Weapon Triangle, meaning they automatically lose 15 points from their A rank Xs, so that's something to consider as well. I think if I drop this wall, she can actually pop this guy and start getting some shield. These guys, these are blacksmiths actually, and their res is so terrible that if she can kill the chieftains, then surely she can kill the savages, or I mean the blacksmiths. Oh my god. Is this gonna be Elise? Well, I'm glad I decided to wait on Ophelia then, because, yeah, oh my god. And if these guys, oh well, that's a battering club. Some of the chieftains actually have magic though, and they will borderline tinker actually, so I'm not even considering fearing for those guys. On this side, though, it's a little bit more interesting, because, yeah, I'm going to push the left. I'm going to push the left, so if I actually just leave this to Elise, then I can actually kill all of these guys, I think. Just eyeballing it, the shield should keep me safe, and they're very inaccurate to begin with. But if we get that far, then the next thing to do would be thinking about this group, because they're the next thing in my way. If I want to one-shot Hana, I need... Oh, wow, really? Wow, this game is so good! So, wasn't Yukimura also... 52? Yeah, Yukimura is 52 because of the gate, and Hana is also 52. Except that, I guess in this case, since we're not trying to double her, it just takes 52 to one-shot her. God, that is no coincidence. Don't even tell me that is a coincidence. Don't even begin to tell me. So they knew what they were doing, so that's always good. I guess I'm looking forward to three houses then. Yeah, they still have their touch, for sure. That's really clever. I like that. Now, I guess... Maybe dude can hit this first Dragon Bane, because I'm going to drop this wall immediately. So dude can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fuck, this game is good. You see that? She actually starts directly in range of this if you gave her the boots, which I assume that the developers knew was a good idea, so that's why it's here and not like here or like one space away. And it's exactly in her goddamn range as if they planned it all along. Love this game. I love this game. Such a good game. these automatons. I feel like Mozu can work them. Mozu's actually fairly strong. Like, Mozu could probably work one. If I leave Leo on this side, he can work the other and then hit the Dragon Bane. And since Leo is so tanky, I could also use him to simultaneously draw this mage. The automaton won't come, but this guy will. So I can, if I put Leo right here, I kill a bunch of shit, basically. So that's probably what's going to happen with the first turn. And then on the next turn, he should also, if he's here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so he'll be in range to hit that one as well, which would then, that would be turn 2, I guess, right? And if I did have dude hit this one, then she could run up and murder Hana, because she can also hit 52 attack easily, I'm sure, especially if I have Camilla on this side. And like, if I'm short, Camilla can just stand next to her and then pop Hana that way. And it would be easier to do this like that, because... I can have at least kill some of these guys on the first turn, first of all. Two of them, in fact, so that's just great. And then, Hana's not going to be getting the first hit on me, because she's actually scary as shit. By the way, Tsubaki's over here too, but if I really need to kill him, I have Mozu. And she instantly drops him without a pair-up, so like, there's that. Well, she does, right? He has 23 speed, she has 28, right? Oh, well, if I gave her the potion or used the speed haul, she would have enough. So at this point we're on turn 2, assuming I hit this one with dude, she is here, which should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, murders Hana. But if I do that... Let's say Camilla has to be next to her, then she's not going to be close enough to Yukimura. So if she's not close enough to Yukimura, that means I need Azura at this point, which means Azura needs to be safe somehow, which would mean routing this group, so I need to do that. Hopefully that makes sense. I would need to route this group, because if I don't, then they can easily just swing around and murder Azura, which they will do, no doubt. And ideally, if Camilla was going to be buffing dudes, she would be here and no other tile, because this is outside of Sakura's range. This guy is irrelevant. Don't need to think about him, really. I guess, well, if I put Elise here, I could also put her here, I think. I think both of those spots work out for the same thing. I could do this, but if I did, I fear that Sakura would, one, either freeze her in place and she would be useless, or she would silence her and then she would lose weapon triangle and probably die. On top of just not being able to kill these guys, of course. But honestly, if I can get here by turn two, then that would mean I can win on turn three. Naturally, because then... Yeah, because I could have Azura up here. Dude kills you. And then maybe I could dance for dude somehow? Because again, if I do this, it's going to be really important to kill all of them. So let's say I kill Hana, dance for dude with Azura somehow. Then can I keep Azura safe? Camilla, I don't want to get her into melee. We know that. Let's say I put someone where Hana is right now. Camilla would be here because I may, in all likelihood, need to buff dude with her. So if Camilla's here, then I could potentially put somebody here as well. And let's... Yeah, since Elise is going to be over here, I could put Elise where Hana is, and it doesn't really matter if she gets silenced on turn two. She'll have Odin in her back pocket anyways. But if I put someone here and kill the right... chieftains, I think that, assuming Azura ends right here, she could be safe. Like, if I killed this guy, Hana, and this guy, I don't even need to kill this guy, actually, looking at it. So if I just kill this guy, Azura from right here can dance for dude, who can then kill another, and then I can protect her by just simply walling up. Right? Because this guy doesn't have enough move, and this guy doesn't have enough move. If I force him around, anyways. So that's where we're at with that. Yeah, that's where we're at with that. How close would Elise need to be to kill one of these guys? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. She would need to be right there. Okay, so now we're actually going to start, like, forming up here. I think that is a solid strategy. If I can drop this wall, then this wall, and the next turn I can drop this wall, I don't think I can both... Maybe. If I were a higher level, almost certainly. But I don't think that I can route this group, keep Azura safe, and drop this wall, basically. I don't think that I can, so there's no sense in preparing for this group on turn two. And if that is the case... First of all, Odin over here. Who's even in? Who's even in right now? And this is a case where I'm going to need an ass load of Dragonbane users if this is going to work. So I think we're going to need to drop some people here. And I'm thinking Selena. I really don't want to drop Niles because that's... getting Nina's going to be a bastard. For sure. But I think we can. Jacob, you're no longer necessary, bud. We can do Gunter. Nyx. And honestly, I'm so concerned with my Dragonbane users that I'm thinking of just summoning Xander at this point. I think I am, because I think that's going to give me enough flexibilities. And actually, as a matter of fact, if I just put him on the left side, he could... Yeah, I could use him for blocking, because he still has a billion defense. Yeah, don't think just because I haven't leveled this guy up a single time he's bad or something like that. No. No. Definitely not. Definitely not. Look at those stats. Those are still crazy, even at this point. 27 defense. So... I think that's the route we want there, so we can move Xander on over. Azura being in the front is only natural. And I guess we can actually use Silas too, because he has shelter. So let's say I have at least killed this guy, because I want to funnel experience in her too, which is why I'm kind of concerned about murdering these Hoshinins with her. Just so I can get Trample sooner and get Ophelia sooner and all that good stuff, but yeah. I can have her stand there. She murders this guy. Azura runs through, dances her. Silas shelters. Now, Dwyer did bring a physic with him, and because Elise could, in theory, get hit. Well, first of all... Yeah, you know, if I give her the tonics and crap, she's fine. So, yeah, that'll be fine. Yeah, I think we'll leave Felicia over here and give her the physic that Dwyer brought along. Because, again, if Elise does happen to get hit enough times, she could theoretically die. But if I have the physic, then I'm pretty sure I can keep her safe regardless. She's going to be getting multiple shield gauges over this round on top of these guys having sub-50s on her. So I feel like that's a pretty confident move that I can make. We already know the thresholds and everything, so... Yeah, I need her to be 39 attack and 29 speed. So that's one potion... Well, two potions, both the tonic for magic and speed. And then again for the mess hall. And then get the support, obviously. So, okay, so far so good on that. If a dude is going to hit that Dragon Bane, she needs the 10 move now. Camilla, as far forward as possible. Really no reason never to do that, I guess. Like, she should basically always be as far forward as possible, in my opinion. Nyx, pair with Leo to get him up to speed for these guys. Yeah, right now they're sitting at... Okay, so I need to do speed magic, in other words. Yeah, I need to do speed magic, which means I might need to get a little bit more creative with Camilla here. If I gave her the bronze four, she would have... 48 plus 2 from... Oh, I didn't get... Yeah, I'm just going to do these right now, actually. So we need to make sure that we do this, because this should bump her up a point of strength, actually, because Arthur gives an additional point at A rank. No, she doesn't have that support with goddamn Leslo yet. Nyx and Leo will do that one, too. I'm not sure that factors in here, but it might. She does give magic, I think, at A rank, so that could be useful. And Odin and Elise... Hit that as support. Yup, that's right. Elise is a mother at the ripe old age of technically an adult. All right, then. Yeah, I'm never going to let that go, by the way. I'm going to make fun of that until the end of time. I don't care. It is just such an easy joke to make. I know it might get a little bit old, but can you even blame me? If the game is going to paint a target on itself and hand me a loaded gun, come on. Come on. I lost my train of thought. Actually, I think we're good to give this a shot. So however long that took is how long this actually takes, by the way. So that said, we can just tonic up, I guess. Yeah, at this point, we can just tonic up. It's going to be speed magic, right? Speed magic from the mess hall. So yeah, let me just buy all my tonics and crap, and then I guess we can just give this a shot and see if this works. Okay, guys, sorry to awkwardly splice in some more audio here, but I forgot to explain one hugely important thing for this map that kind of explains my rush this crap mentality. So you're gonna see me use the Dragon Veins on this map. We've already covered that at this point, but I forgot to mention that Sakura can also do that, and she will raise the levies back into place, which is just awful for you if you get your unit separated or something like that. So that's also kind of in the back of my mind as I'm playing this, so keep that in mind. I didn't bring it up. Hugely important to this map, though. So oh, by the way, I guess I should show this. At this point, you can also buy the chef's hat from the accessory store, and I did do that and gave it to Perry because she is by far the best cook. So we know speed and magic is what we wanted. And I mean, well, whatever. I'll just show myself buying the tonics too, I guess. We know we needed the one for Dude so that she can one-shot Hana with Camilla's support. We need one for Camilla so that she can one-round Yugimura. We need one for Mozu if she's gonna hit the automatons. Well, maybe we don't. Let's see what we actually get from this. Maybe we just get strength outright. Exquisite pudding. And at this point, if you upgrade the mess hall to max level, it also hits everybody every single time. So there's no worry there. I don't have to reset to get the correct people or anything. Yeah, there we go. Plus 2 defense, actually, which... So now I don't actually think I need to buy a tonic for Elise. I was kind of considering it just because that would... in combination with a health tonic, go from a 2-hit KO to a 3-hit KO, I think, because she had 18 defense. I'll be honest, I wasn't watching that very carefully. I'm just going on the assumption that she's going to survive. Because really, she should. There should not be really any worry about that. But we said we do want 3 strength tonics. 2 speed tonics, I think it was. Well, let's be honest, if I overbuy a speed tonic, I'm still going to have use for those, so it doesn't really Doesn't really affect too much there. I'll buy 2 health tonics, 1 for Leo and 1 for Elise. Leo's going to be taking a beating on the first turn. I think I actually do need 2 magic tonics, though, because I was eyeballing it. Like, because when we hovered over these mages, I think that they actually had a little bit too much res for Leo. Otherwise, and he does need it for the automatons, I know that. Because he's actually... Yeah, he's actually 2 points short right now. So that is necessary as well. I think that was actually everything. So that was actually a fair bit of money, obviously, but it is what it is. It's definitely worth it to be able to get these necessary KOs and all that. Dude really only needed that, I do believe. So you need the magic tonic, and she also needed the speed tonic to hit the... Actually, we got... No, we don't need the speed tonic. That's right. We don't need that for you. So maybe that... Yeah, I think I actually just overbought right there. We know you need one of each. Nothing else really, though. Where's Leo? Leo, where are you at, my man? I should just do it like this, honestly. Let's see here. So you get the health tonic and the other magic tonic. So now you can one round. Maybe... Oh, yeah. Leo needs... That's right, because he gets 5 from Nyx. And they had... Yeah, I would need 28 speed, so... Yep, there we go. I knew I needed 2 in the back of my mind for some reason. So... Right, and the strength tonic is from Ozu. That's right, because she, well, you'll see, she can one round the automatons. I actually don't think I pointed that out, but yeah, she one rounds the automatons with the poke if she has this, basically. And I don't think I'm forgetting anything else. Like, I'll double check, obviously, just so as to not waste time and all that. But I think that that's it, really. So we can just repair Gunter, you here. Right, and there were those last minute changes as well. I wanted to double check everything, so you get the hit points. The physic, of course. Yeah, Dwyer comes with the physic, which is really nice of him. I'm gonna take that, give it to Felicia. She is on the left-hand side, after all. Oh, hello. Hello, what's up? Pair those two. Save again, because I'm an idiot and didn't do that the first time, and now... Let's just give it a shot. Seize. Okay, let's go. By the way, new map theme, and this is my favorite one of the game. Oh yeah, make no mistake, this is it right here. This is flames right here. Hot fire! So we can hit that vein, we can hit this vein. Oh god, that was almost so bad. Imagine throwing on the second move of the map. Just real quick, just imagine that for me. Anyways, we blow those guys away. I should be... Okay, sorry, my bad. So now we can take Elise. Have her murder the crap out of this guy. And I can't believe how good of an idea this is, guys. Look at Elise go. Look at her go. Camilla Jr. over here. Literally 2 big differences between her and Camilla, honestly. Oh, her strength and her defenses. Come on. Get your mind out of the gutter, guys. Let's go ahead and dance for Elise, though. Throw her right here. I think this is the spot. And that's actually going to have the benefit of killing this guy, which is just extra experience on her at this point, honestly. So I'm feeling like she can probably get trampled after the next map. Assuming she's half as good there, she should, in theory, be here. With Felicia and Xander. Again, we're just going to switch these two. Drop Xander off right there, which will protect Felicia from that last guy who outright one-shots her. Silas can pick up Azra. I actually don't even need to do that, do I? I'll just do it because Silas needs to be there anyways. This is the only time that they can reprise Lost in Thoughts that it doesn't bother me, by the way. Oh, I didn't give her the... Ooh. Well, I'm actually going to end up right next to Dude, so that's whatever. Irrelevant, really. I'll give her the Killer Axe in case that guy decides to be an idiot and attack Camilla for some reason. He won't, but... Let's just say, man. Now, as much as I'd like to give this kill to Laszlo, it actually just doesn't work out, because if Leo should happen to miss, I'm gonna need the chip from this as well as Poison Strike. Yeah, so that puts him in range of just 1 hit from Leo, which is, it's much safer, honestly. Let's just go ahead and turn these on, because if I've done this correctly, this is not gonna be a long map. And from here, Mozu plus Laszlo. I think I'm actually going to try to gimp Tsubaki just for the hell of it. I don't have to kill him, but I think if I get in his range with the slow, he should come down for him and get himself killed to Mozu, basically. You certainly have Mozu. Way to go. Now, unless I miss like 270-somethings, which would just suck, honestly. Yeah, his name is 273s. This should be a dead automaton. Oh, I just turned the animations off. My bad. My bad. Level up for Leo, though. It's going to be sick, right? I like how his bad level ups are still really good. There goes B-Rank Domes. Now, if I would have had that beforehand, I don't think I would have necessarily needed to buy him a tonic. Magic tonic, anyways. He still needs the raw durability tonics, though, because if not, then after he got debuffed by that dang old, whatever you call it, the hidden weapon launcher, if he would have gotten debuffed by that, then that would have been pretty much it for Leo, because he's not going to have enough concrete durability to survive otherwise, but he only needs to take two more attacks, and one will be blocked. So he is good, essentially. Like, it's not. Oh, he needs res. Bad at math. Bad at math, man. Oh, my god damn it. Oh, I'm so bad at math. I like how when I try to prove a point, everything just still backfires. And I get lucky as shit. So what I should have obviously done there was just give him a res tonic and he would have been fine. I am so trash. Good god. I can't even be mad. I really can't. I really can't. To be honest, I didn't really remember exactly what the debuff was from the Ballisticians. I assumed it was less, I guess. Any growth is good growth. He got the same level up twice, really. Wow. So there was the one and only time Brynhildr came in. Why didn't he have the javelin equipped? When did I use that? He should have had the steel, obviously. That might prevent me from killing that guy, actually, with Silas, which would have been nice. I don't need to do it, but it would have gotten him more experience, at least. Yes, that was a misplay. And I'm going to, of course, tank the 39 with my base. And we're going to get a crit, which might actually be worse because that's less shield gauge.
Not bad. Not bad.
But I agree. Not bad. Not bad.
You know, if she pulls this off...
Yay!
And she gets even better, of course. If she pulls this off, I almost wanted to say that this is a good idea. Like, Mage Ignite Elise in general. Because... I don't know, she's been really, really broken. I can't lie. This is good, clean fun. I almost want to argue that... I don't know, I feel like there could be a fight to be had for Mele Ignite Elise, I guess. I feel like that could be a legitimate discussion over instantly changing Corrin. Has Corrin not getting the first heart seal actually cost me anything at this point? Like, even a single turn? Even a single turn? Because if the answer is no, then why is this not a good idea? Well, I guess that's why this is not a good idea, right? that might come back for me here. Really badly. Damn, an 87, huh? An 87, huh? Okay, so now this gets a little bit trickier because I... Well, this is a risk-free move. That might have actually screwed me, huh? Well, okay, let's start with this at least. Leo, drop the wall, because this has to happen regardless. But now I don't think that, because Ashura needs to be here, and Felicia gets one shot. Well. This is a move still, right? Yeah, this is a move, right? And Silas should still not actually die to this guy, assuming... Where was that 17? The Blessed Lands, why? Oh, it loses defense or something, I guess? I guess I hadn't noticed that. Yeah, so I can actually even still attack with Silas. On enemy phase, that is. Now, Camilla can be here. I can trade her the old Axe Forge. Oh, I needed to take the Duel Club anyway. Hello, hello, my planning! It all falls apart. But we can do this. Right? And hey, I just realized those two savages by Hana didn't even come for me. But that doesn't change anything at all, actually, because I can still get Dude to the same spot because she has lunch. And I'm just... Yeah, this works. Okay, so now, with the Duel Club... Yeah, that's what I thought. That is exactly what I thought. Good night, Hana.
You're finally here, Lady Dude. I am Hana, Lady Sakura's retainer. I'll have your head on a platter.
Huh? With those stats?
Shut up! I can never, ever forgive you after what you did to Lady Makoto. You tried to destroy Hoshido and you made Lady Sakura sad. More importantly, obviously. Do you have any idea how many nights she cried herself to sleep over you? That's why I won't be satisfied. Not until I kill you myself. So Hana has like a crush on Sakura, right? I think. Are you crying? Shut up! I'm not crying, you're crying! Samurai, don't cry. You're just trying to distract me. I won't cry and I won't lose. You won't hurt my beloved Sakura ever again. Okay, yeah, clearly she does. You absolutely will not make it past me, probably, 23% of the time. You won't!
I will!
Goodbye!
I should've drank.
Probably. Lady Sakura, I'm so very sorry. I've lost. Forgive me. And she's actually dead now, by the way. I'm pretty sure we're actually killing the retainers. Finally! So no running away here. Right, that's why this doesn't work, because this guy is still alive. Which cannot be... That literally can't be fixed. That literally cannot be fixed. This can be fixed, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, so that was fine, but... Huh. Man, if only it were the throwing club guy, I think we're gonna take an L. I definitely think we're gonna take an L. I don't really feel like that was... I don't feel like that's necessarily a situation where I need to make any adjustment, though, because... That was just unlucky, basically.
Your battle is over.
Is there any way at all that this works out? Besides Azura dodging, I guess. Which is always an option. I mean, shoot, because Xander could have been here, is the thing, which would have... And I mean, if I'm not going to do it, then like... If I'm not going to go for the strategy that I figured out, then like... I guess we see what happens, but I'm fairly confident that Azura will die because of this. This guy would still need to die regardless, and since I do have a shield gauge, I would not have needed the physic. But I had to move Felicia in the way that I did because by forcing him through the forest, he can't catch me, whereas if not for that, he could just run up on me, I'm pretty sure. At least insofar as positions from which I could have attacked that chieftain. He could have attacked Felicia, thereby killing her. Because what should have happened was something like this, and then dude could have... Well... No, this won't work. This won't work. Nope, that was it. That was it right there. Because this guy can still reach, and this guy can still reach. But had Xander been here, they would have had to go extra space and would have ended right here instead, thereby protecting Azura. And if I don't do it like this, I can't actually seize to begin with because this guy didn't move. And if I can't seize, then it gets bad because I know there are reinforcements on this map too, and they come from these forts behind you, and I believe I have triggered them by this point. So you, 17 defense, 22, I live. I guess let's just get him over here for the hell of it. This is going to be an L though because if I'm going to win at all, I must lunge this guy. I must. It's not even a question. It has to be.
Surrender. This is my chance.
So I guess this level's going to be at least. So it's a good level to look forward to, I suppose, but that's an L. Without a doubt. Yeah, goodbye, Azura, probably. How lucky would I have to be for this to work? Yeah, that's what I thought.
So this is how it ends.
Wah, wah. You know, as frail as Azura is, this is actually the first time I let her die. So there's that. Wait, her secret truly what? Oh, Azura, knock that shit off! Knock that shit off! You're not that mysterious! Ha! Huh? I'm just kinda curious at this point if... Oh yeah, and Silas can die this way as well due to the fact that Azura was exposed to begin with. Is this the first time Silas has died as well? I think it is. See, I guess now we can see the fact that nobody actually dies. They're all just retreating, actually. Oh, and I didn't even give Dwyer a weapon, so yeah, that wasn't really... I wasn't really worried about this, but he should have a weapon, just for the experience. And it looks like Tsubaki is a little bit smarter than that.
but it's not like it matters. Okay, let's try that again. That's a really easy fix. All we need to do is not miss, ladies, goddamn. I guess alternatively, instead of having Camilla here, I could have had anybody with Savage Blow just do this. Which would also put Hana in range. So I guess I didn't actually need a strength tonic on dude thinking about it. Yeah, I could have just done that. Yeah, that would have been smarter, I guess. Huh? Okay, how do we get it? You love Sakura. Goodbye, though. So now we can do what I was actually going to do, and since Elise did actually take a fairly large beating here, I'm going to bring her back with this physic now, and this is still outside range for that chieftain. So yeah, we can just do that. Elise can pop the guy on the right-hand side. I think we did this last time, but... No, actually, I don't think we did, because we had to kill the other guy, that's right. But this is what I would have done, essentially, and then Xander can now move here safely, which gives Ashura enough room with Silas' backpack to run in here, sing like so. I guess I could have even unpaired Silas from Ashura, right? If I wanted to. But I guess, no. I needed to pissing there, though, because of how Elise got body bagged. But now if I do that and then have dude lunge right here with a dual club, she cannot miss. So we can just do this. Dragon Fang destroyed. Don't even need to take that counter. All right. Now, unless dude gets frozen or something, but I imagine that they would actually... In fact, we already saw that Sakura is going to go for Elise. So that's that, really. Now I can turn these back on. Oh yeah, 78%. Maybe I dodge. That'd be cool. Ah, you know, if I actually dodge a silence, I think I could kill Sakura. Maybe not from this position, but I think that that's what would have needed to happen for me to have a chance here on that. Now Dwyer does have a weapon. It doesn't really matter that much because he's, as you can see, he's still not exactly doubling these guys at this point or anything like that. But Chip is Chip. Chip is definitely Chip. And it's not like he's been specced out for combat on this map anyways, right? He's purely here for the Dragon Bane. And if he can do that, he's doing his job as far as I'm concerned. Now, on Ophelia's map, the thing was that originally I had it planned out that he would be able to one-round all the Berserkers on that map, because he can. He absolutely can from where he was at right now, so I don't know if I might have to rethink that strategy when it comes time to do her map, because I don't know that he'll still be strong enough at that point, if that makes sense. So now we can hit you with Elise, I think is probably the way. And then Dwyer can hit this one. And then we can kill Yukimura. Right? Yeah, I think so. Now, had this guy moved a little bit differently, we'd still be okay, because I have alternatives. He's only on 1 HP, even Felicia could do it. Silas is up here as well, who can still take one hit from these guys. Well, maybe not. They do have stronger posts. They do have stronger posts, but I could throw a javelin with him, yeah, so that would have been fine either way. At least, since she's silenced, I mean, this is only the logical move, right? Right? And then Dwyer pops this one, which is going to give us an avenue of attack on the boss. Yeah, so here we go. It's getting down there. And I mean, I'm just going to make this move first because I do know that Camilla has the potential to miss this guy, surely, just because gates are kind of bullshit. And they always have been. So how close does Camilla need to be? I guess it doesn't really matter as long as she's in range of Ashura, so we move her there. Boom. Get yold and dance. Kind of unfortunate again that I couldn't unpair Silas, but it is what it is. Boom. Move on over to Let Me Ask. 71 times 2. Yeah, those are good odds. Those are good odds. Let's get it. Those are really good odds, actually. This game does have true hit over 50% after all, so, you know. My brain against your brawn. Let us see what Sheldon comes out on top. Gee, I do not know. I have Weapon Triangle and everything, so, there's that. Thankfully, we don't eat the debuff mid-battle, and that's good game. Yeah, that's good game. I can't lose from here. Lady Makoto, I'm sorry. And he's dead too. So now finally, 20 chapters into the game, there's actually death in Fire Emblem. Who would have thought? She's so good. It's just so much better now. Look. Look, it's over. It's actually over. So Camilla just got 6 points stronger, if you can believe. And Yukimura is even going to bring us plenty of rewards. And if I really want to, I mean... Let's get one for Felicia. Actually, yeah, and you can see all these mages, by the way, and I think they come multiple times, and these guys, like, oh, you don't want to be caught between these guys, basically. And I think that it is proximity, so if you advance in the map far enough, you will inevitably be sandwiched between these two groups. Like, that just kind of always happens by the way that the map is designed. And same thing down here. And we really don't want to be dealing with these guys because they are nasty. They are nasty. So that's not really my scene. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to balance, really. If I could get her a kill, but staff experience is probably better. Yeah, I could bring her up to be probably before the end of the game. So let's do that. Is there anybody else left to move? Right, I paired these two strictly for the purpose of doing this. Because I don't like Tsubaki. Oh, I missed the L button. I'm sorry. I'll defend this fort as well as Lady Sakura's honor. I'm literally, dude, Kaeldori. Oh my god, get so destroyed. If Kaeldori were a man, this would be Tsubaki. I actually lost. How clumsy. Well, I say that. Did I say Kaeldori? I meant Cordelia. His kid is Cordelia. They're both perfectionists. So yeah, Mozu creams everything as usual. But it's like such a useless... It's not really useful to be able to do that. But it is nice, I guess. Certainly very entertaining, especially if she's going to get level ups like that. And I don't really care about Xander at all, to be honest. But I might as well get the kill. May as well get the kill. Alright, we're done, C's. Map clear. Elise and Odin kicked all kinds of ass. Just see that? She just killed everything. Everything, dude. On the first time, too. I didn't have to reset or anything for her crappy accuracy. Certainly not. I can definitely see where Heartseeker for her would be sick, but I just can't see myself spending the money to dip into Sorcerer just for that. Honestly, not at this point, anyways. Listen well, Hoshido Army. This fort now belongs to Nor. To fight back would be futile. Throw down your weapons and surrender. Do as I say, and the lives of all remaining soldiers will be spared at the command of our leader, Dude. Yeah, somebody brought that up, that everybody just orders Dude around constantly. And then in the next sentence, they'll be like, but you're our leader, though. not a very good look for you there, Corrin. I'm afraid we've been outmatched. Oh, Yukimura doesn't die. That's right, Yukimura and Sakura get to live. Everybody else dies. That's right. We have no choice. None who remain are in any shape to continue this battle. The wisest path open to us is to surrender and live to fight another day.
I'm sorry.
I'm so sorry. I should have... only I were...
No.
Nonsense, Lady Sakura. You fought bravely. I'm quite proud of you. The same goes for you too, Tsubaki and Han. Oh, they lit? I swear we killed these guys. Or is it just...
Huh. I honestly thought we did, so I guess we don't even do that. I guess there's not death in Fire Emblem at all.
Yukimura, this can't be happening. We really lost.
I'm sorry. We really lost, didn't we? I just don't like Tsubaki. I feel like I would not get along with Tsubaki at all. I just wouldn't. He's just kind of a prick. Truth be told. And not even like in a fun way like Shinon. He's just... I don't like him.
Yes, I'm afraid so, but we're still alive. As long as we live, so too does our cause. Let us lay down our weapons now. It's time to surrender. There's no reason for any more blood to be shed on these stones.
You're right, Yukimura. It's over.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Hoshinin Army, this is the last time I will repeat myself. Don't make me sick, dude, on you. or Elise, apparently. that's too funny. The Norian Army has climbed this fort on its own. Or has claimed this fort for our own. Surrender now and...
We heard you the first time, Crown Prince of Nor.
Then you should have responded sooner. Lest I mistake your silence for cowardice. Or do you still intend to fight the inevitable?
No.
I think not.
No, we do not. You have won. The Hoshinin Army surrenders. All remaining soldiers have been instructed to lay down their weapons. We do so in good faith that you will at least spare our princess.
You have made the right choice. Your fallen queen would be proud. In return, I promise that your princess and your troops will be spared. Soldiers, bind the prisoners, but under no circumstances are they to be harmed.
Sir!
Yeah, yes, my lord!
Which is true, at least we're going to keep our word on that, as I recall. Sakura, Yukimura, please forgive me. I know it seems cruel, but this is the only way to end this awful war once and for all. I know you don't understand now, but perhaps one day... Oh, right, I forgot. Yeah, hands is a dick.
Huh?
Huh? I forgot. Yep. is this really all you Hoshinin rats are capable of? Pathetic. Hands, what are you doing here? I thought we were done with you, man.
What is the meaning of this?
What is the meaning of this? You swore to spare our soldiers' lives if we surrendered.
Please, no.
No, please. I need to heal them right away or they'll... Yeah, they'll die. Please untie my hands. I swear I won't try to escape. Please, just let me help them.
I'm afraid that's not possible.
And this guy too. All these jokers. I'm afraid I cannot allow that Princess of Hoshido.
Hiyago, of course.
Ah, if it isn't Princess Dude, sorry about trying to murder you for the last 5 maps now. My, how easily you seized this fort. Yeah, he's wrong. He's right about that. Even a broken clock, right? What a truly impressive display of brute force. King Garon will surely certainly shower praise upon you for this grand triumph.
What was that?
I cannot care less about praise right now, Iago. What's the meaning of this?
We were just so worried about our young princess. We came to help. Now that we're here, just leave the messy part to us. General Hans here is all too eager to put these sorry Hoshidans out of their misery.
No.
No, you monster. Why do we put up with this guy? Is Garon even here? Can I just one round him right now? Can I do it? I think I can, so like, can I just... Okay. Battle is won. I will not allow you to take the lives of unarmed soldiers. Stand down now.
Oh dear, how awkward. You may wish us to stand down, but you see... Die, die, die! I'm just having too much fun! Gah!
God, ow. Dude, my headphones are jacked up. Sakura, come on. No, please stop it. Please don't kill anyone else. I beg of you. Please.
No.
That's enough, Iago. I order you to stop this madness.
You...
Damn you, insolent fool! Stop this cruelty now, or so help me, I will kill you myself! Finally!
What?
You can't be serious, Lord Xander. I'm not known to make light of serious matters, Iago. I refuse to harbor a cruel and spineless general in the proud Norian army. Anymore, anyways. As Crown Prince, I will not hesitate to strike you down for the honor of Nor.
You fail to understand.
Not today, Xander. Stand down. Oh, goddammit. No, it cannot be. Go round. Oop, hold up. Mabi, father!
Listen well.
My orders have been given. I will not allow anyone, even my own child, to disobey.
Father?
But father, Xander was just speaking common sense.
None of that here. Did I not make myself clear? Disobey and die.
All right. Understood.
Good. Let that be the end of it. Liars, cowards, filthy Norian scum! Why didn't I keep the gag going, goddammit? I will never forgive you for this, never! You're all monsters, demons, devils!
How could this happen? Oh my god, she's like, why are we doing this? I actually feel a little bit bad. But I mean, not too bad, because it still fades. They were supposed to be safe. This is just too cruel. My
well
poor little
done.
Heart can't take it.
You've done well, my children. Of course we have. Hoshido is as good as conquered. I am proud of you.
I mean, honestly, I just... You know, I... To be honest, if the writing up until this point in Fates had been better, I think the endgame would be much stronger because of it, but... Here's the real issue, right? Can anybody at all explain to me even a single thing that we accomplished from chapter 11 until now? Like, even one major victory we had that actually moved the story forward, you know? And I know I mentioned this before. I didn't go back and rewatch the entire playthrough up to this point or anything, but I know for a fact I must have brought this up. 90% of this maps in this game just go nowhere. Like... We're not doing anything. We haven't actually made any progress towards the goal of conquering Hoshido until right now. We jerked off with Garon for so long that, like, nothing really came of that either. So, for the first time in how many chapters, I don't even know, the plot's actually moving. But by this point, personally, I lost interest. I know I said that last time, and I'm saying it again, too, this time. This time, you know... With this part, I can at least sort of defend a little bit, because we're kind of almost telling a story now, but
I don't know. I feel like if stuff would have happened sooner, maybe this game wouldn't be as bad when it comes to the story. But for me, it's too little too late, man. It really is. It really is. Oh, yeah, I didn't show this, but we can also just feed Lilith, despite the fact that she is dead as dirt. So there's, though, oh, Lilith, and then the cabbage just evaporates, and I'm not shitting you. Now, in the invasion battles, instead of Lilith, you get, like, this spirit who functionally does the same thing. So gameplay-wise, this is totally inconsequential that she's dead. Story-wise, it's inconsequential that she's dead because the story wasn't finished based on what you guys are telling me. So, yeah. Oh, A-rank for dead Lilith. Cool. She still gives you gold bars as well, by the way. Anyways, I think that's gonna do it for me. I really do like the entire endgame of this game, though, as I recall. Not really a whole lot to complain about. I think there's probably a few maps that might be debatable, but I'd have to give a more solid opinion on those once we actually got there. This map, though, I think is great. Not just because it can be done quickly, but there's actual incentive to do that, too, because, again, those reinforcements will ambush you in the worst possible way. Now, granted, they're not ambush spawns, per se. Not in the same way that, say, New Mystery is, but their positioning is still really bad. Their positioning is still really bad for you, because then you have to divide yourself even one more time, right? Because you're already divided at the start of the map. And then if you want to cover both your forward and backwards positions, you need to split your army again. And at that point, you're being ran kind of thin, you know what I mean? So I appreciate what they're going for with that map. The Dragon Vase themselves are used to really good effect, but again, you do need Royals. How many Royals did I even bring out of that map? Like 5, at a minimum. Like 5 Royals, and that's really disappointing, I will say. From the perspective of somebody who likes to vary their team from playthrough to playthrough, you know? Especially if you wanted to, like, meme it up on Lunatic mode, it's a lot harder to do that in this game because the game literally necessitates that you have certain characters to do certain things. It's not a Fire Emblem 12 situation where, actually, one of you guys told me that literally everybody in that game can potentially damage Medius, which means that everybody in that game can kill Medius, right? But it's not the same thing here because not everybody can fulfill every job, you know? It's gotta be a Royal for the Dragon Vase. Really, if anything, it's more comparable to Marth, I guess, right? Where Marth has to be the one to hit the villages and has to be the one to seize. But even then, that's more interesting because the whole game is designed around the fact that it is literally only Marth. Whereas here, there's some options, but you're still very restricted in who you can and can't use, you know what I mean? But aside from that, very good map. And that's gonna do it for me, so thank you for watching. Hope that y'all enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.